Beijing, Li Chuk began carving ivory after leaving school at 15. Today, at 68, this master craftsman is working until the early hours of every morning, trying to finish a 50-centimeter statuette of Buddha on an unforgiving deadline, before China implements a total ban on ivory sales at the end of this month. The art of ivory carving survived even the tumult of China's Cultural Revolution, but he is worried it may soon die out. What makes China great is that its traditional culture still exists, he said. If it disappears in China, it will be a loss for the whole world. Yet China's commitment to put craftsmen like Li out of business and close down its ivory industry has thrown a lifeline to African elephants, and brought new hope in the battle to end the poaching of tens of thousands of animals every year for their tusks. The Chinese government shut down 67 ivory carving workshops and retail outlets in March, and will have closed the remaining 105 by the end of this year, honoring a commitment President Xi Jinping first made alongside then-US President Barack Obama back in 2015. China's ban is one of the most important things that has happened to elephants in the last 10 years, said Ian Douglas Hamilton, one of the world's leading elephant conservationists and founder of Save the Elephants. It's a highly significant step, and I think the impact is increasingly being felt in parts of Africa. But although the net is tightening, the battle is not won at all. Poaching levels have dropped slightly in each of the past 5 years, according to research for the Convention on Trade in Endangered Species, CITES, but the total number of elephants in Africa is still thought to be declining because of illegal killings. Stronger law enforcement efforts have also pushed ivory seizures up to a record high. Even more encouragingly, the looming prospect of China's ban appears to have pricked the speculative bubble that had contributed to the poaching crisis. The wholesale price of raw ivory in China is reported to have fallen by almost two-thirds in the past 3 years, from $2,700 per kilogram in 2014 to $950 in February 2017. China had been the world's biggest ivory market. Until this year, craftsmen were legally allowed to work with ivory from a stockpile imported in 2008, but that business provided cover for a vast illegal trade. Rising wealth, a growing appreciation of ivory as part of Chinese cultural heritage, its value as a status symbol and popular gift, a sense that it was an inflation-proof investment, and its use in Buddhist beads, pendants or figurines, had all combined to create a boom in the industry, experts say, and a huge opportunity for global crime syndicates to exploit. At the peak of the ivory boom, in 2010-12, more than 30,000 elephants were slaughtered every year, research showed. But the global conservation movement fought back. Instead of pointing fingers, advocates made China feel part of a joint effort to end the trade, involving source countries, transit countries and destination countries, said John Scanlon, CITES Secretary General. It helped that 11 wanted to curb corruption.